All right, folks, welcome into the Cowboys Report. I am your host, Tom Downey. We'll take you through some preseason reactions from today. First up, the injury report. The big one, of course, is Zach Martin. Now, he did leave Saturday's game with a knee injury. The reported initial diagnosis is only a hyperextended knee. The Cowboys don't believe it's serious, but they will still do an MRI as of right now. The results of that MRI have not come in. So nothing to panic on quite yet for Zach Martin. I slept okay about the injury for Martin. I'm not overly concerned about it, but it is worth monitoring because, as we'll make note of several times during the show, the Cowboys' backup offensive linemen looked pretty bad. They cannot afford to lose Zach Martin for an extended period of time. So as of right now, we're not going to panic about Zach Martin. I think he'll be okay. I think it is going to be a relatively minor injury. But we have been burned before about, oh, the doctors think it's a minor injury. Then they go look at it more in depth, and it's a more severe one. For example, Tony Romo in that Seahawks game. Doctors thought it was a minor back injury. Turns out that's not actually the case. So I'm going to put it around a 3 or 4 at most on the current injury worry scale. I'm not hitting the panic button by any means yet, but it is worth monitoring. Also, a big one is Xavier Woods. Now, he came up with a hamstring injury in that game after I thought he actually just banged knees with A.J. Green. Turned out it was actually a hamstring issue there. No word yet on the severity of that injury for Woods. Hopefully, he is okay. Again, the Cowboys do not have the safety depth to survive without Xavier Woods on the field. It'd be a mess without him because it'd be Jeff Heath, Kevon Frazier, and a bunch of nobodies, quite frankly. Maybe the Cowboys will go sign George Iloka, who was just cut by the Bengals. I love that move, and we'll talk more about that later on in the week. But hopefully Woods is okay. I thought he had a great pass breakup to even get to that ball and kind of take it away from A.J. Green. Nearly picked off the pass as well. But hopefully Woods comes back healthy because, as I mentioned, look, they don't have the depth to survive an injury to Jeff Heath, Kevon Frazier, or Xavier Woods. I'm putting this one more along the lines of a 5 or a 6. He got right up after the injury, but then was in some pain afterwards. So I think he'll be okay, but it is worth monitoring. And of the guys hurt so far, I think the Woods one actually has me the most concerned because it's the one we know the least about. Couple of the ones here to get into, as you mentioned again, the offensive line has had issues thus far. Hopefully Zach Martin is okay. And then for defensive backs, Jeff Heath, Xavier Woods, those are your two starters. Kevon Frazier not listed there either, or as a good backup. Not listed there is Jameel Showers, the strong safety. And that's the big one for me in terms of actual knowledge. The report is that he has likely torn his ACL. In reality, that ends Jameel Showers' season. He's going to go on IR. It might actually end his career as well for the Dallas Cowboys. You don't know how much longer Showers is going to last. I believe he's out of practice squad eligibility. The Cowboys think he tore his ACL. Again, MRI today to confirm that. That means he'll be on IR. Maybe he gets a chance again next year because the Cowboys seem to love Jameel Showers for some reason. But I didn't think he was going to make the roster. Either way, it's another seed that the Cowboys have lost due to injury. That's worth noting. All right, next up, Bo Scarborough left the game against the Bengals with a hip injury. Severity is not yet known, but Bo, after a very strong showing in week 1, 4 carries, -2 yards, and a hip injury. Not exactly what you would like there. He was on the field before Darius Jackson, so I think he's still the number 3 in that regard. But Jackson looked very good, who we'll talk more about later on in the show today. So Scarborough goes down with that hip injury. If it's severe, he'll be an IR stash for a year, and then the Cowboys will bring him in, try and get him more playing time potentially next year, especially with Rod Smith eventually hitting the open market and might become a starter somewhere else in the NFL. And then one final injury note, Dayton Jones. I think it'll be a minor knee injury, but I'm not sold on that yet. And again, we'll wait to hear more information. The Cowboys will be cautious there. Interesting to note there, Daniel Ross actually got the start at the 3, I think, which was a big surprise to me. Dayton Jones came in afterward. Jones is the guy that I like more than Ross. He's a guy I think can, as we saw last year, help out on the defensive line. A knee injury for Jones. We don't know about the severity, but I think he's a key reserve for the Cowboys, and I think he makes the roster. Hopefully he's okay. I'm pleased with how well Antoine Woods has played, but I don't want the Cowboys to have another injury up front on that defensive line. They're already thin enough as it is.